Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I'm going to talk about that why the manhole door is cut elliptical in a boiler. Why? Means in every pressurized cylindrical equipment, the manhole door cutting is elliptical. Why it is so? After that, we will see how the manhole door is cut and what are the equipment provided in a manhole door. After that, we'll see the design, and after that, a very talkative question that why the boiler is made cylindrical, why it is not a square shape, why it is not a rectangular shape, why it is cylindrical shape. So that question will be covered, and after that we'll see how the boiler is made and examined. So please remain tuned till last, you will learn a lot. So this is the part 2 of the boiler series. In part 1 I have talked about the stresses in boiler, what are the circumferential stress, what are the longitudinal stress, and what this stress is causing. So please go and watch this video. Before watching this, you will understand better. Right now it is showing in I button, please click on that and you can watch that video. So let's begin the video, why the manhole door is elliptical. So as you can see, this is the longitudinal stress, longitudinal joint, and this is the circumferential joint. Okay, this is circumferential joint, this is a longitudinal joint. So as I have told you, the manhole door is cut in elliptical. Why? Because as I have told you in my earlier video that the longitudinal stress is twice as compared to the circumferential stress. Means if the stress acting like 4 newton in the circumferential joint, it will be acting 8 newton in the longitudinal joint. So to avoid crack development or to avoid stress larger acting on a boiler cell, the door are cut elliptical, and the major axis is in the longitudinal direction, circumferential direction, and the minor axis is in the longitudinal direction. So for that reason, the door are cut elliptical in shape. As the stress is maximum in longitudinal joint, so the cut in the longitudinal joint will be minor, okay? And major cut will be made in the circumferential joint direction. This is the circumferential joint direction and this is the longitudinal joint direction. Therefore, the shape of the manhole door is elliptical. And to have a stress minimum effect when a hole is cut, at that time the manhole is cut elliptical. Now, whenever a hole is cut in a boiler, whatever the size of the hole, the strength of a equipment, if a hole is cut in a pressure vessel, is reduced to ensure that the component is compensated. A compensating ring is welded around the body so that the stress can be compensated which has been lost, and the boiler can withstand the stress which is acting on a body. So for that reason, a compensating ring is provided in a manhole door which has been welded. Okay, now as you can see, this is the inside of the boiler. Okay, this is the inside of the boiler and this is the outside of the boiler. Okay, so here the compensating ring is been cut. Now the second thing is that, as you can see, this is the manhole door. Okay, this is the manhole door, and this is the long nut studs, and this is the dog nut which is holding the manhole. As the door is elliptical, and to ensure positive closing, it has been closed in this fashion. Means from this direction it will be closed, so that the pressure building up here is also helping the positive closing of the manhole door. As the boiler is a high temperature working cylindrical vessel, it need certain clearance for expansion. Means a 1.5 clearance is provided on either side so that a thermal expansion region is provided. For that reason, a clearance is provided in both sides to allow thermal expansion. Okay. And long stud having a good resilience can induce and can withstand good stress. Okay, so for that reason, the boiler is designed in this fashion and is closed from inward side. And for that, and for to ensure the strength of the boiler is not lost, the compensating ring is welded to the boiler cell. So, compensating ring is provided to provide additional strength to the boiler cell when a manhole door is cut. To provide positive closing, manhole is placed in a such a way. Okay. This is the top view. This is the manhole dog nut. This is a long studs and this is the manhole. Okay. This is the manhole. This is the long stud and dog nuts attachment. It's closing from inside. Okay. Now the second question come to our mind, that why the boiler is made cylindrical, sincere. So as you can see, when a body is subjected to a stress, a force is applied, at that time a component to withstand that stress is automatically, the balancing stress is automatically induced by the cylindrical shape body. Means when a cylindrical shape body is subjected to a force, that balancing force to withstand that stress is automatically generated without causing much deformation in the body. But if a same thing is applied to a plane surface like this, it will have a distortion like this, and as it is unable to generate the balancing force. So the cylindrical shape having a quality of generating the balancing force to withstand the stress, for that reason we are preferring the boiler to be made cylindrical or semi hemispherical in shape. The flat surfaces are unable to generate this balancing force, and for that reason, if in low pressure boiler the surfaces are somewhere flat type, need to be provided with a stay such as this to withstand the balancing force. So now what is happening, if we have provided this, when a force is induced, this is pulling it down. Balancing force is provided by the stay when the force is applied, and hence the surface is remaining intact. If it is not provided, it will bend like this. Okay, now if a cylindrical surface is subject to a press force F, the component of the stress to balance is doubled like this, and the bursting stress will act in a perpendicular to the radius. Now this is the hemispherical end plate which require no internal stay, and this is the flat end plate which require internal stay to support it. So if a flat surface use cannot be avoided in boiler construction, then a flat surface must be strengthened by the internal stay, okay, to support them, or its thickness would be increased. So basically what we have come to our conclusion, that if we are not using a cylindrical surface, in that case, to ensure that the flat surface can be able to withstand the stress, the thickness of the surface need to be increased. If we are unable to increase the thickness, in that case what we can do, we have to provide stay. The thickness is not increased so much because it will ultimately lead to a poor heat exchange and unwanted increase in the weight and the material cost. So it is better to provide stay. As in case of the hemispherical end plate, it cannot accommodate and balance internal pressure without the need of internal stay. So as I have told you, hemispherical end surface or cylindrical end surface doesn't require any stay because it can balance its force without the requirement of internal stay. Now we are going to see how a hemispherical end is made in a boiler. So as you can see, this is the hemispherical body which is been molded, rolled out, and then it is been joined. The 2 point is joined by help of a welding, precision welding. Okay, after the welding is carried out with the X-ray element, the welding seams is been monitored to ensure that is there any defect, welding defect is there or not. If it is there, in that case that part will be again scrapped out and again welding will be carried out, and again the X-ray inspection will be carried out to ensure that the thing welded pressurized cylindrical vessels are welded properly. So I hope you have understand today how the boiler is made cylindrical and how the manhole door is constructed and why the manhole door is elliptical. So all your doubt will be clear. Please do subscribe and share my video, and please subscribe. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.